Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about what a CSTR is. In particular, we'll talk about how they work, what they're commonly used for, and develop an equation for them. CSTR stands for Continuous Stir Tank Reactor. Unlike our previously talked about batch and semi-batch reactors, CSTRs operate continuously, which we can also refer to as steady state. Well, what does a CSTR look like? CSTRs are commonly just a tank. This could be small, like a pilot plant, or very large for an industrial setting. In this tank, there is some stirring apparatus that moves and agitates the fluid within the reactor to promote better mixing. There are tons of different designs for the stirrer, many of which are best for a given situation. However, this is not important as of now, but it may be something to consider in the future if you are ever designing a reactor. Additionally, there could be several inlets feeding the reactor and an outlet to remove the reacted product. CSTRs are one of the few ideal reactors that we will study throughout the duration of this course. Remember that an ideal reactor are just to give us a fundamental understanding of reactors through simplified ideal conditions. CSTRs have a few associated ideal assumptions about them. Firstly, we have nothing changing in time since we are at a steady state. Now, realistically, when we begin a reactor, there will be a period where we are not steady state. This is known as the transient portion, or the transient region. You can imagine this through the changing concentration of a reaction product here. However, when we are analyzing CSTRs, we are more often than not just interested in the region that is not changing in time. A second assumption about CSTRs are that they are perfectly mixed. This means that the mixture within the CSTR is so well mixed that the composition, temperature, and other characteristics of the mass anywhere within this reactor will give us the same results. So, because our CSTR is a steady-state reactor, that means that when operating, we will continuously be feeding it reactants and removing the products at the same rate. The idea here being that the new reactants enter our tank, stay for a certain time period, this is called our residence time, how long a particular particle will stay within our reactor, and then leave our reactor once the reactant has become a product. Some advantages to CSTRs are that they give us a lot of control over the components within our reactor, such as the temperature. They are relatively simple and therefore less likely to break down. Additionally, they have lower labor costs as cleaning the machine and running them are both easier compared to more complex reactors. Our control over things like the temperature are due to the perfectly mixed assumption that I mentioned earlier. If we had a heating or cooling jacket over our CSTR, the energy is obviously going to be applied to the walls of the reactor. However, since the mixing is so good, the convection of heat is quickly going to reach a steady state. Therefore, we have excellent heat transfer occurring. Additionally, CSTRs are great as they are both simple and cost-effective. Lastly, and we'll talk about this more in a future video, but we can put multiple CSTRs in series to achieve a higher level of conversion. So, now that we know what CSTRs are great for, let's talk about some of their disadvantages. Firstly, CSTRs are not great with viscous fluids, and this should make sense, right? Imagine we had something super viscous, like molasses, in our CSTR. The agitator would have a hard time moving that fluid, and therefore our well-mixed assumption is just invalid. Or we would need a very powerful motor and a strong paddle to shear the viscous fluid. Additionally, it is also known that the conversion of a given reactant in a CSTR is not as volume efficient as some other reactors. Therefore, we may need a larger reactor to ensure that our reactants are sufficiently reacting to become products. In terms of industrial use, these types of reactors are commonly found in industries where less viscous fluids are used and where a steady state is ideal, such as wastewater treatment facilities, fermentation, or some other multi-step processes, just to name a few. Okay, so now that we have an understanding of what CSTRs are, what they look like, and how they work, let's develop a general mole balance around our CSTR. We introduced the mole balance in a previous video, and I will leave a link in the description below if you're interested. So, I've just written the general mole balance here, and we can eliminate any terms that we don't need. Just remember that we mentioned earlier that the inlet and the outlet of our reactor must be equal. Otherwise, we would not have a steady state, right? So, this means that our accumulation term will be zero. And this will always be the case for a steady state system. So, we just have the moles of component A coming into our system, minus the moles of component A leaving our system, plus the amount of moles generated within our reactor. This generation term here could also be the consumption of A, or both, depending on what part our component A plays in the reactions of interest. Just note that GA just stands for the generation or consumption of component A. Therefore, it is equal to the rate of formation in terms of generation, or the rate of consumption in terms of consumption, times the volume within our reactor. We will talk more about this in coming videos, though. There's actually one more interesting thing that we can do with this equation for CSTRs. We can solve for the volume of our reactor simply by rearranging our equation here. This is called the general design equation for a CSTR. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your fundamental understanding of what continuous stirred tank reactors, CSTRs, are and how they operate. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.